Is that crazy? What was I thinking? So we are doing a Q&A about the tiny cabin in New York, which is the house right behind me. We're gonna be answering questions that you guys have asked me. All right, here we go. My favorite question, I'm dying to answer this.
Ready? What is it, what is it?
What wildlife have you seen?
Oh my God, you guys have no idea. This woman, I knew she, you know, liked animals, but she is losing it over seeing animals every day. Like every day when I'm in my office, she texts me, did you see that baby groundhog outside?
It's a baby groundhog visiting us. Just walking around the fire pit, checking out the logs. I was standing on his back feet. I think he's still figuring out his balance, so he fell. It was so cute. And then we see deer every day, at least probably 5 deer a day.
Yeah, she's in love with deer. She's in love with deer.
They're so cute, and they're babies. They actually have the spots like Bambi in the Disney movie. And then every night I walk uphill on our property and I see a bunch of deer, and they make all the crazy sounds like horses. We've also seen a fox. And immediately after seeing them, I look up the spirit meanings of those animals. We have a ton of birds. I've seen yellow birds, bluebirds, vultures. We have a hummingbird that feeds
a hawk
right there.
There's tons of cows and horses and ponies and goats, and we've held baby goats.
We
pet a donkey. You forgot about these things. Oh, there's ducks and chickens down the road.
Oh, and last night, oh my gosh, coyotes. At night, coyotes go
crazy.
Oh
yeah, coyotes.
It's kind of scary because they're so close, but you can't see them. And they're so loud, and they're always in packs.
Terribly long.
It's creepy. I would not want to be here alone at night. Anyway, next question. We might come back to more animals if we remember more. And you might see stuff in the background and hear the birds, so be on the lookout. All right, next question. How you budgeted to buy and how you make money now? How you find high quality groceries and daily routine? Okay, that's a loaded question. So let's start with how you budgeted and how you make money now. This is probably the first question we get when we tell people that we moved from Brooklyn to the country is, did your husband get a work transfer? And then I tell people that we both work from home, we both work from our computers. So for me, nothing has changed. Most of my business, there's two sides of my business. One is content and working with brands. Like today I posted something in partnership with Whole Foods. And then another part is teaching social media. And both these things are completely virtual. Sometimes I get to attend events and go to stores and do in-person things. But most of the time it's just I shoot content, I write the copy, I publish it, or I record my podcast and I don't have to be anywhere for it. So in terms of work and how we make money, nothing has changed other than there's not that many seductions and things that distract us from being focused.
Besides carvings, I can't stop carving wood. I've been carving birch, walnut, apple, and black birch spoons and totems and stuff like that. And what I do for work is I have a digital marketing agency. Someone asked, how are we getting along?
How are you and Eric are getting along in that tiny space? Has it been a difficult adjustment?
You know, there's been tons of things that have been difficult since we've moved in. I would say this relationship has been the easiest thing. There's been so many things, like we've gone through all these things that you see on TV if you've lived in an apartment your entire life that you didn't know that existed with homes. Oh no, the toilet's kind of leaky. What do? We have ants in our house. Like there's no landlord to take care of things, so.
That's the biggest adjustment, learning how to take care of stuff yourself, being responsible for maintaining a property. I've been learning gardening and landscaping, and just at first it seems so overwhelming. And then after watching a couple of YouTube videos and actually trying it, you realize that you can learn anything.
I spent 45 minutes fixing our chainsaw yesterday. My hands got so oily. Well, I did learn how to use a chainsaw. We cleaned up and then we chopped them up and we made a huge fire. And that was pretty cool. There's a lot of really cool things about living here. The weather's amazing right now. Who knows how crazy it's gonna get in the winter. Someone also asked, is your home insulated for the cold weather?
That's right.
The answer is it's insulated for the cold weather, but there's a couple things that are missing for it to be like good for the cold weather, which is we only have one heat source, which is the electric heating, which is expensive, I guess, technically, but we don't have a wood burning stove and we don't have a backup generator. So there's no way for us to get warm if the power goes out. So we're not prepared like that. Plus the door freezes shut because of the frame expansion and contraction. So we need to get that done again.
So we're thinking whether we should put some money into renovating the house or perhaps just escaping to maybe Argentina or Australia or Austin. What do you guys think? Give us ideas. Back to the question of how are we getting along? We went from 1,000 square foot apartment
plus
to 340 square feet. The good thing is that it's two spaces with two separate entrances. So Eric's office is in a different side of the house, and I kind of take care of the bedroom that's also the living room and my office and the kitchen and the dining room. It's kind of like a studio setup.
Definitely, like it's like the tiniest studio you've seen.
The kitchen is separate, so that's nice, and the bathroom is separate. Eric goes off to his office and he just goes crazy all day. He works away and I only see him when it's mealtime. And we have 12 acres, so if anyone needs any space, we have plenty of space.
We have pear trees, which have no fruit right now, but they're healthy.
No, there's definitely fruit.
Wait, there's pear trees that are growing fruit?
Yes.
Are you serious?
Yes. And we're going to have thousands of apples. We have wild raspberries and blackberries.
The raspberries, like, they're so small, and the animals eat some of the best ones right away.
I don't have
the patience to pick them, but there's blackberries that are coming, which I imagine will be just as tough.
In terms of how we budgeted to buy a house, we didn't. We just kind of...
Bought it.
We looked at the rent we were paying in Brooklyn, and then we looked at what the mortgage would be here, and it made a lot of sense. And we knew that even if we are making any mistakes along the way, if we have higher expenses than we predict, it will be fine because our mortgage is like almost a third of what our rent was.
Mm-hmm. Except like just buying the driveway that we bought, and then buying like getting the
a car,
property,
big things like that.
Yeah,
that which are longer term.
That cost as much as our mortgage for the entire year, actually. But not including some of the other stuff, like there's taxes and all this. It's like, oh my God, are you serious?
All right, so next question is...
And then we bought a weed whacker, and we had to buy a chainsaw, we had to buy all these other things. So I wouldn't say it's cheaper, I would just say like it's more fun for sure. I don't feel lonely, and she doesn't feel lonely. Become friends with people and
there's an amazing yoga studio. That's actually a question that was one of the most often asked.
And it was often the thing that you were most afraid of, remember? That there wouldn't be any yoga or exercise nearby.
Right, I forget. I honestly am like in a haze about the whole time period when we made this decision. Sometimes I look back and I'm like, was I crazy? What was I thinking? Because it's definitely a lot of learning and a lot of work and a lot of opportunity to grow and expand and become a kinder, more compassionate, more present person. And that's probably the biggest invitation right now, to just know that we're guided every step of the way, to not rush into making renovations or building decisions, and to just enjoy the moment and breathe more slowly and be present and get to know the land. And so with that, the question that comes up a lot is groceries.
And, that's not tough.
So there's a really cool health food grocery store about 18 minutes away driving. They tend to have really good stuff. Farmers markets are incredible. The tomatoes and the cucumbers and the sprouts taste,
for,
and the bread.
For now, they're incredible.
Tastes so good. It's quite expensive, but that's how farmers markets
are. Oh, it's terrible. These farmers markets are crazy.
But we're growing our own kale, so that's good. I had no idea how to do it, but now we have kale and lettuce and spinach, radishes, and a bunch of other things that we're growing for the first time. What else? Groceries? Or some people say groceries. Actually, another question
Who says groceries?
I don't know, I hear people say that.
No, it's not a thing.
So people are also asking for the tour of the cabin. I'll show you some snippets. I've been taking pics as it comes. And then also design and storage tips. So I've spent hours and hours and hours researching how to buy things for tiny home, how to organize things in a tiny home. Are there like special organization tips for smaller spaces? And there's not anything like that really. I've just spent a ton of hours looking for things on Amazon, on Bed Bath & Beyond,
Home Goods. Home Goods, that's TJ Maxx and Home
Big
Goods.
Big time. And a lot on Amazon, to be honest, too.
But hold on, let me just interrupt. You think that because like this is, it's a small home, that it's some sort of sexy TV tiny home that like people planned out perfectly with all this storage? Yeah, that's definitely not it. It was probably built by some like, you know, hunter who wanted a place to just
be a man,
and in his mind, and just like chill while he was.
I mean,
in
this
hunting
is the kind
season.
Of thing he had in the house.
Yeah, this was the thing that was above
on top
the door
of the doorway.
These horns, we took them down. And we're not like against horns in general. It just it looked bad.
Do you know anyone in town? So when we moved, we knew no one. One of the reasons we chose this place is because neighbors have really cute animals, miniature horses and ponies and goats, and that really got me. And just the forest and the trees on this property are just magical. And
when she says we, she means it's her.
Yep. And we have an observatory on the property, which also got me, which we haven't really used besides that one time yet. If you know any astronomers, send them our way. We didn't know anyone, but it's interesting because there's a lot of people from the city moving to this area, and I'm finding that there's a lot of friends of friends. So I'm getting to know people and learning a ton. And there's, in the Hudson Valley, it's more developed, it's more known, more expensive. And there's a lot of connections that I've been developing there, and I'm going to some events. But for now, we're just enjoying the simplicity of it.
It can stay exactly how it is. I'll be happy.
One more question. Tell us about your origin.
I'm from the Upper West Side.
And I am from Moscow, Russia, and Australia too. And I've been in America for 10 years or so. Something got in my eye. There's like always bugs. You never know when they're going to attack you. And in terms of the tour, I'll give you guys a tour and stories, and check out at Tiny Cabin New York. That's where I post more pictures of our house. And in terms of rituals, that was an often asked question too. I am going to film a YouTube video showing you my morning rituals and what it looks like here in the cabin.
When I can get her out of bed.
In the morning, I usually water the garden, and that's my favorite ritual. And in the evening, at sunset, I take a walk to the top of the property to look at deer and drink my cacao. Thank you guys for watching.
Bye, y'all.